What's going on, fellas? So today I'm going to talk about how alpha males lose out to beta males and how players lose to suckers. I had a consultation with a guy, man, alpha male type of guy, you know, good looking, got his shit together the whole nine. He had an issue with a woman and, you know, she kind of left him for a dude who was kind of soft and, you know, just a sucker or and a P-U-S-S-Y. I don't want to curse because it's too early in the video, but you know, this guy was like the beta male, like a sucker, like a simp type of dude. And it bruised this man, it bruised my man's ego up so bad, man. He was like this, that was like, that stung more than, you know, the chick actually leaving him was the kind of guy that she left him for, right? Which was the sucker, the beta male type. And, you know, he's the alpha, you know, he has his confidence and his you know, his arrogance thing going on. So when you lose to a guy who you know that's not on your caliber, and you know that's not up to par with you, it kind of stings a little bit more. Well, guys, you have to understand something. This is going to happen, and this is a part of the game. Players are going to always lose women to suckers and simps. Alpha males are going to always lose women to beta males. Here's why. When you have, well, one of the reasons why, when you're a player or you're an alpha male or you're a ladies man and you're a guy that's good with women, and I'm teaching you guys how to be good with women, so you guys are going to come into this thing to where, you know, you're going to want to be out here in the field and dating around this shit. Well, some of these women, and they're going to be good submissive women, some of these women are not going to wait on you forever. So when they leave you, not only is that going to sting, but when they leave you, they're going to be hurt. So they're not going to want to date anybody that reminds them of you. So they're pretty much not going to date your type, the player type or the alpha male type. They're going to date the suckers when they're vulnerable. They're going to go for the sucker, the guy who's usually not their type. You know, I did a video on the flip side of when how a girl comes to you when she's vulnerable. Well, they're going to choose guys who have more simpish energy, so they don't remind themselves of you. So, because it's like they shell shocked from, they got this guy who's never emotionally, he's not emotionally available, he don't want a commitment, he's fun, he's exciting, he's good looking, but you know, it hurts that she has to let him go. So when they date the next person that they date to get their confidence back up, their esteem back up when they're vulnerable, it's more than likely going to be the beta male guy. And this is how you lose to these guys, and it actually stings. With me, nowadays, it doesn't really bother me any much that more, but this shit used to bother me back in the days. It would be like, how you gonna stop fucking with me and go to a sucker? Like, how you gonna stop fucking with me and go to old buster ass dude, like a sucker? Eventually, they come back around, right? But it's like, you know, this is what happens, right? When you out here, you playing the field and you don't want to commit, and you know, like I say, a lot of women, they'll wait on you. You know, you're not gonna be able to string them along forever. A lot of women are smart and they're hip to that. You know what I'm saying? So it's gonna come a time to where you're gonna lose good submissive feminine women to sucker dudes because you don't want to commit or you don't want a relationship and shit like that. You know what I'm saying? And that's going to bother you. I remember one time I was dealing with this chick for like, you know, a year and a half. Very submissive chick. Nice chick, pretty, gorgeous, submissive, cooperative, feminine. But you know me, I didn't really want anything. I didn't really want a commitment. She wanted to be in an exclusive relationship, to date for marriage. I wasn't with that, so I drug it out as long as I can, and I got my benefit out of it. Well, she got tired of it one day and, you know, walked away. And it's like shocking to me. Not that I simped and I chased to try to get her back, but it's like, God damn, like, what's going on? Talk to me. You know, okay, you don't want to do it. Fine. It stings. Whatever. Take me a couple shots of Hennessy when I used to drink. Take me a couple shots of Hennessy. Go work out. I'll be good. Whatever. So I look on her Facebook page one day. I see a post on her, and it's this. She is with the corniest dude ever, and that stung. It's like, how do you go from it was offensive, like, how do you go from me to this? Like, I didn't understand it at the time, right? And the thing is, like I said, these guys, they make them feel better. They get their confidence back up, you know, because these guys shower them with dates and money and attention and affection and shit. And this makes the woman feel good. Eventually, he's going to lose out again to the alpha male and the player. So it's just a back and forth thing. But anyway, this chick, you know, and I end up, you know, not taking her back, but I end up hitting her and shit while she was with the dude. I actually felt bad for the dude, but this guy in this guy's mind, he would think that he won something over me or that he took her from me. You know what I'm saying? So that's a way that alpha males lose to beta males and players lose out to suckers. And like I say, the cycle just continues, because when that chick get her confidence back up, when that chick get her esteem back up and she's not vulnerable anymore because you're not really her type, you know, the sucker is not really her type. When she get that back up, he going to be out the door and she going to be on to another player. She's just going to be smarter and play the game wiser, and she going to have all type of barriers. And, you know, when she on the date, first date and second date, she going to be like, I'm dating with a purpose. And, you know, she going to be asking you where is this going a lot sooner. She's just going to be smarter. But she going to go back after she used that sucker for what she need to get out of him, which is the attention, the time, the affection, the confidence boost, the self-esteem boost. She's going to go back to her player. So if you're a simp or a sucker, then you need to understand that as well. So, you know, because I spoke about this from the other side, but this is what happens to the simps and the suckers. They get the girl who was hurt by the alpha male and the player. You know what I'm saying? But this stings, though. So you guys have to understand, when you guys are coming into this knowledge and getting your game, you guys, it stings. It's going to sting you. But eventually you get numb to it. So understand that this is what's coming for you guys who are trying to get in the dating game. Good, submissive, feminine, cooperative women are going to be walking away from you because you don't want to commit or you don't want a relationship, which is fine. At least you can have your respect instead of faking a relationship and cheating and all that shit. Don't ever do that. You know, let them walk away because you'll have the respect in the long run. But kind of went off in a rant. You guys have to expect that this is going to happen. The more it happens, the more you get numb to it. But you are going to lose good, submissive women, wifey material and all that. That's if you're not trying to be committed. You're going to lose them to suckers. And that the initial them walking away from you because a submissive, cooperative, feminine woman is a real alpha man's kryptonite, right? So when that leaves you, that stings, right? And you have to be damn near, you know, listen to me and listen to what everybody else teach, but we teach you how not to simp and chase when all that shit happened. But that really stings. And then to find out that she stopped messing with you or she left you alone for a complete sucker, a complete buster. It's almost like a slap in the face. It's almost like, how can you disrespect me? But you guys are going to have to expect this. As I said, the more it happens, as time go on, it does get easier. And then you just laugh at it. But I remember initially this used to really bother me, and I was on my consultation and my man was bugged out. He didn't understand it to save his life. So guys, understand that this is one of the ways that alpha males do lose to beta males, right? And beta males win over alpha males, and players lose to suckers, and suckers win over players. And you know, you can say, oh, well, he got the leftovers. The beta male got it's I guess it's a win, because you guys will say, oh, well, he got the leftovers. Well, when you got her, she was left over from somebody. You know what I'm saying? She was left over from a beta male who was left over from a player. It's just a cycle continues. So you can't really look at it like, oh, well, he getting my leftovers. No, because she was leftovers when you got her too. So, you know, sometimes we do take L's and we lose to beta male. Guys, I want to thank you for tuning in. Thank you for, you know, watching all the way through. I need you guys to like, comment, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. That way you can get this good player shit fresh off the press. Y'all know my slogan, playerism is the antidote to feminism. Oh, and if you're new, I am your gracious game advisor, yours truly, King Dre. Guys, go get both of my courses, Attraction 101 and How to Make a Woman Fall in Love with You. I'm actually revamping Attraction 101. Go get that right now, because when I get done within a week, the price is going to go up significantly. It's $100 right now. It'll probably be around the area of $550 to $600. So go get that right now. And also go get How to Make a Woman Fall in Love and Obsess Over You. Guys, join my private Discord community and Facebook community. I'm going to leave both of those in the description. And if you need a consultation or one-on-one session, I change your life. This is what I do. Hit me up. I'm really good at what I do. I've coached countless guys into success with women and life. So hit me up. I have an abundance of experience, in dealing with women successfully for over 20 years. So hit me up on there. If I'm forgetting anything, I don't know. I forgot. Yeah, but that's it, guys. I appreciate you guys for tuning in. It's your boy, King Dre. Oh, for the consultation, send me an email if I didn't say that. Send me an email or DM me on Instagram. But anyway, it's your boy, King Dre. I'm gone.